This is another showcase that I did with Obelix to show how pikes can be defeated frontally. We have pike units in different formation widths and densities. These three pikes are 2 ranks deep, these three pikes are 3 ranks deep, these three pikes are 4 ranks deep, and these three pikes are 5 ranks deep. The advantage of having pikes 2 ranks deep is that you're going to be able to close off a significant portion on the battlefield. They're still going to be effective against cavalry, and they're going to be able to hold for some time against infantry at least. But having them 2 ranks deep is going to mean that there are only two ranks fighting frontally. And the amount of ranks fighting frontally are going to increase as the formation depth increases. But as you can see, it only increases up to 3 ranks deep, where pikes that are 5 ranks deep will not have 5 sarissas protruding from the front. They will still only have 3 sarissas. So you might think that the best formation is having pikes 3 ranks deep, and there is some merit to that line of thought. But let's just see here. If I'm going up against pikes that are 2 ranks deep, and I'm going to go in 3 ranks deep myself, let's see what happens. So the pikes are initially going to be able to hold off some of the legionaries, but then the legionaries are going to be able to push through because there are only 2 pikes fighting frontally. And since the melee attack of the standard pikemen isn't great, that means that they're going to be missing a lot against the legionary cohorts, and then the legionary cohorts are going to be able to push through. Pikes with a higher melee attack would be able to get more hits in, and it would be more difficult to push through them even when they are 2 ranks deep. But elite pikes do not see a lot of use in the game currently. So here we're going in a very dense formation. It's going to mean that more legionaries are going to be able to push through in the center. But more legionaries are going to get hit as well by the pikes. So already we can see that the legionary cohort that was 3 ranks deep is making it into the pikemen to quite a significant degree. But since they are standing here, it means that the pikemen that aren't engaged are going to be able to push against the legionary cohorts and do quite a lot of damage to them. In the center, the same thing happens. Legionary cohorts are going to be able to push through in the center, but they're going to get hit a lot by the pikemen in just standing here. So another thing that we can try against pikes frontally is going to be to go into loose formation. And going into loose formation is going to enable the legionaries to be in a wider formation. It's going to allow the legionaries to have more men on the flanks and less men in the center. And it's going to make less men be hit in the center due to them being spread out further. So the pikes are starting to take casualties here, but the legionary cohort is not doing very well, but most of the legionary cohort has now made it past the pikes, and they're able to get into the pikemen and do a lot of damage that way. So against pikes 2 ranks deep, a unit like legionary cohort is going to be able to defeat it frontally, but it's going to take significant casualties, and it's not a good engagement for the legionary cohort. But if we go in 3 ranks deep and in loose formation, what's going to happen is that less pikes are going to be hitting the legionaries, more legionaries are going to be able to make it in between the pikes, and the pikes are going to be outflanked on both sides. So you can see how quickly the pikes are dropping when the legionaries are in loose formation, and how little they are losing. So against pikes that are spread very thin, 2 ranks deep, going into loose formation, if you have that option, is going to allow you to defeat the pikes very comfortably frontally, and actually have a lot of legionaries remaining. You only lost 36 legionaries by going into loose formation. So loose formation can be effective both in reducing the amount of casualties taken from missiles and the amount of casualties taken when charging pikes that are spread thin. So going in against pikes that are spread thin, matching the pike formation is not going to be good for the legionary cohort. Going into a dense formation is going to be slightly better than going wide. But going into loose formation and going wider than the pikes is going to mean that almost twice the amount of legionaries survive than if you just match the pike formation. So here we're going to go in much wider than the pike formation against pikemen that are 3 ranks deep. So you should be able to wrap it around to a significant degree against the pikes here. But the pikemen that are fighting 3 ranks deep frontally are going to be able to do more damage to the legionary cohort, even though the legionary cohort is able to wrap around and do a lot of the damage, to the pikes by getting into the rear. The legionary cohorts that are in the front are going to be killed off very quickly indeed. So the pikes are actually holding off very well here. Even though they are outflanked to such a significant degree. So most of the legionaries that are standing in front will absolutely get massacred when the pikes are 3 ranks deep. And if we don't try to go in wider than the pike formation, if we just go into a dense formation when the pikes are 3 ranks deep, they're going to be able to, the rear ranks, when the legionaries get through the first 2 ranks, are going to be able to stab at the legionaries, and the legionary cohort is not going to do well in this engagement at all. The pikemen haven't lost a single pikeman yet, while the legionary cohort has lost a lot of pikemen. So if we try to go into a loose formation and we spread out, it's going to be much better for the legionary cohorts. They're going to be able to wrap around directly. More legionary cohorts are going to be able to make it through, and the pikemen that are now engaged at the side here are not going to be able to fight frontally against the legionary cohorts that are in front. So look at how quickly loose formation is going to be able to make you going to defeat the pikemen. Loose formation is superior against enemy pikemen that are spread either 2 or 3 ranks deep. Here we're just matching the formation against 4 ranks deep, and that's going to be bad for the legionaries. Here we're going to go in wide against the pikes that are spread, that are 4 ranks deep. But you can see how effective the loose formation is against pikes that are spread 3 ranks deep. You're still going to take more casualties when the pikes are spread 3 ranks deep than when the pikes are spread 2 ranks deep, but it's decidedly more effective than matching the formation width. It is decidedly more effective than just going in with as wide a formation as possible. And against pikes that are 4 ranks deep, the loose formation is superior. Here we have pikes that are spread 5 ranks deep. And matching the formation widths against pikes that are 5 ranks deep is going to be a disaster, but I'll just show you how much damage you can do with precursor javelins here. You're going to take down a lot of pikemen. When you're going in just wide against pikemen that are spread 5 ranks deep, you're going to be able to outflank them to a significant degree. If you go into loose formation, you're also going to outflank them very effectively. They have a much wider flank to get into. But again, the legionary cohorts that are in the front are not really going to be able to push through the pikes that are spread 5 ranks deep. But the legionary cohorts on the side are going to do very well against the pikemen. So 5 ranks deep is going to give pikemen the maximum amount of bracing and the ability to fight very well frontally, but it just gives them such a narrow front, and it gives them such a large flank that it's going to be easy to move around. They're still going to be able to kill a lot of legionary cohorts when they are spread 5 ranks deep. The problem is that they won't be able to close off a significant portion of the battlefield. Still, these are not great engagements for the legionary cohorts. They're going to be losing a lot of men. So the exception is going to be, let's have a look at the results here. The legionary cohorts that are in loose formation, like this legionary cohort and this legionary cohort, is going to do, overall, it's going to do better against pikes that are spread fairly thin. So in 2 or 3 ranks deep, going in loose formation and going in wide is going to be effective. When the pikes are 5 ranks deep, it's actually more effective to go in. It's less effective to go in to loose formation. It's more effective to go into a wide formation. Or the ideal scenario is when you're able to use your precursor javelins and then just fire at the pikes and then charge in. But loose formation is going to be slightly better than going into a dense formation when they are spread 4 ranks deep. If you're going to just match the formation widths of pikes that are 4 or 3 ranks deep, it's going to make you lose that engagement heavily. And this is what you'll see happen if the pikes are standing next to each other and you aren't able to get around the pikes. Then you need to split up the pikes, shoot them with missiles, and move around with your troops. But against pikes that are spread thin, going in loose formation is going to enable you to defeat the pikes decisively. Ideally, you don't want to fight pikes head-on, but if you have to fight pikes head-on, and they are spread thin, going in with loose formation can be a nice way to ensure that as many of your men as possible survive. Strength and honor.